Today we're talking with two beauty professionals from Westake Village, Loreniza from Tiffany Turnham Beauty and Nikki Corzine from Canyon Salon. Thank you so much for being here. I know you're both busy at home with small children, so I really appreciate you being here today.
So thanks for joining us today. We're super excited because we have two people representing an industry that you have missed so dearly over the last 7 weeks. And well, look, let's just see for ourselves here. I can't go outside no more. I need new things to do indoors. I cut my hair.
Nothing resonates more than that video because last night I did my own hair ever. And so I dearly miss our personal care professionals. So thank you so much for being with us today. And today we're all looking forward to your reopening as soon as possible. What protocols are you working on to ensure the safety of your hairstylists and clients?
Well, we're still working really hard on what that's going to look like. But, you know, our first and foremost, our concern is the safety of the clients and of our staff. So, you know, as far as social distancing, we will be spreading out our stylists. We're going to be actually skipping every other station. So the amount of stylists working will be half. We will, you know, no longer have a waiting room. Essentially, we're going to ask people to wait outside or wait in your cars for your appointments. And then as far as safety and cleaning, we're really ramping up our cleaning schedule, of course. We'll be wiping down and disinfecting our stations between each client to ensure, you know, that we're following the guidelines and the regulations. And each one of my stylists are taking a barbicide certification course, just to ensure again that we all are up to date with, you know, the proper disinfecting and cleanliness of the salon.
So, do you have a date that you'll be opening? Or I know you're stage three, but is there any yet?
Yeah, so we're stage three, and you know, we don't have a date, unfortunately. I think Newsom said it would be months, not weeks. We are hoping, since we're in Ventura County and there's been much less, you know, of the COVID-19 in Ventura County, that we'll be able to open sooner than months away. So, you know, we're hoping July, at least July, you know, July 1st would be awesome if we could open in June.
So when you do reopen, which is, it's really, it seems like a long time away, but it's just right around the corner because of everything you have to do to the salon to make it safe for when it does reopen. What is the most important thing to consider when you reopen?
Just again, to ensure that we're taking all precautionary measures to protect everyone by meeting all the regulations. So, you know, first and foremost, our clients and of course my staff.
Okay. And then what's one positive thing your business has gotten out of this pandemic?
You know, we've just, we meaning my team, we've really all come together and supported one another through this. And, you know, we've really kind of all pitched in and brainstormed with coming up with new systems and new protocols. And I mean, essentially it's like, you know, rewriting a business plan. As we reopen, and obviously it's not, well, not obviously, but hopefully it's not going to be forever. This is temporary. So, but you know, it's the saying, oh, you don't know what you've got until it's gone, kind of a thing, right? So we, my team, we miss each other so much. But most of all, we miss, you know, creating and connecting every day with our clients. And so we just can't wait to get back to that. And, we just realize how much we love what we do.
Oh yeah, we're social creatures and I love going into the salon. I mean, it has a lot of energy, positive energy, and you just bounce off of each other. So it's a great environment, very clean always. And I can't even imagine how much more spotless that's gonna be, but it's a really beautiful salon. And I thank you for doing that. Oh yeah, I mean, I definitely, if you open tomorrow, I'd be back in.
I think people can withhold going to a restaurant. They definitely can hold off for a while going to a movie. they're going to be waiting at your door when this is completed. Because you are not just essential, you're super essential.
Right, right. Yeah.
Everybody I talk to agrees that's the first place they're going.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Good to hear. It's good to hear.
Yeah. So thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Next, we have Loreniza, and she's been in the business for 15 years. How is your business going to change their protocol for your clients?
Well, as of right now, like my top priority in reopening my business is to make sure my clients are safe as well. I mean, I think everybody in the industry is aiming for the same thing. We will all follow guidelines that are set by the state and within our field with Board of Cosmetology to assure the safety of our clients first and foremost. You know, we don't know exactly when that's going to be moving forward, but we're waiting for that. And then they're going to let us know how we slowly can open up to our clients. So it's just important that we pay attention to the things that they say so that we can follow those guidelines. Also, speaking with clients beforehand to see what they're comfortable with. I mean, some clients are very comfortable coming back right away. Some clients are very cautious with everything. And so I think getting feedback from clients is important as well, prior to treatments. Of course, like we do it anyways, is keeping our work area clean and sanitized between clients, before and after clients. That's really just key anyways. I was planning on wearing, because I'm in a room, so it's a little bit of a different setting. It's just a client and myself in a room. So I was going to wear a mask and gloves, of course, changing that in between clients just to make sure they feel safe. And, you know, that was my plan moving forward from here out until, you know, it's safe enough that we don't have to do that anymore.
Yeah. I mean, you're like, sorry, what?
Which probably will take some time, you know, but that's really what I'm planning on doing as we head back.
Yeah, like you said, you have an individual room that's yours, and you're gonna it's always very clean in there anyway, but to separate clients and have no waiting room is a great idea.
Awesome. And making sure I'll probably take care of clients in my room as far as rebooking their appointments and charges, and then having them just leave the front door without actually having to interact too much too with people outside in the waiting area, which again, we're going to have to change that whole, system up as well. Everyone can't be in the waiting room together. It's not a big space, so I'm not too worried about that. I'm sure we'll be able to fix the chairs and have some people wait outside and things like that. Oh. Which I'm sure everyone's willing to work together as well, because we've all been in this together. So it's nothing new to anyone, which is nice, right?
It's absolutely right. We have to work together to make this work as a community and as individuals.
Absolutely.
When I heard that this was going to be longer than I anticipated, I called you right away and asked what recommendations you have for some mask and skincare products. So, and I went right out and bought them, and I love them. So how would you suggest maintain your skin during these times? What do you recommend?
Well, first and foremost, I think it's important that we all kind of get back on a schedule. We're not on a schedule right now, you know, so rest again. You know I've been really bad at that, kind of going to bed later and waking up earlier. And I think having good rest helps with your skin. It also helps build your immune system when you're getting enough sleep. So that's one thing. Hydrate and then get back to a healthier skin regimen again. Basically just getting back on a schedule. I think we all need to do that because we all got pretty relaxed with things.
Yeah. Well, those are all good suggestions. And we go by what they say meds, which is meditate, exercise, diet, and sleep.
Yes.
So if you're not getting those four elements, you've got to get back to it. And it's so easy to get out of the routine now. So those were great suggestions.
Yes.
And then when we go out now, we are washing our face, we are washing our hands. I think we wash our face more times than ever, but how often should we wash our face?
Well, you always want to cleanse the skin twice a day, morning and night. Night is very important. I always say you want to wash the day off. You want to wash the oil off your skin, the makeup, bacteria, SPF that you're wearing, basically just being outdoors, you know, with pollution and everything else. I always like to do a double cleanse at night. One, to wipe away everything we just said, and then two, to cleanse the skin so that you prep the skin for your products. So your skin can actually be clean and, you know, the products are able to do their job, what they're supposed to be doing. And then in the morning, a lot of people think they don't need to cleanse in the morning because they cleansed at night and all they did was go to sleep. Well, your pillowcase is not the cleanest. I know a lot of people don't like to hear that. But if you think of all the products in your hair and everything else, and then you're laying on your pillowcase and now you're rubbing your face on your pillowcase and hands. So it's just good to do one quick light cleanse in the morning as well. You know, you don't want to use a heavy cleanser. You want to use something that's light, that's effective too on the skin. That's not going to be stripping the skin.
Yeah.
So I just do one light cleanse in the morning, or you can do, you know, one of those cleansing waters everyone's using to wipe the skin down, something like that, before you start using your products.
So every time I leave your office, I have a very beautiful, healthy glowing skin. So what do you recommend for home care to achieve that?
So your skin will look dull if you don't exfoliate. That's a big thing. It's the best way to brighten your skin. There's two different methods of exfoliation. There's chemical exfoliation, which I'm sure you guys have heard of, like AHAs, alpha hydroxy acids, BHAs, beta hydroxy acids. Those are, AHAs are like glycolic and lactic acids. BHAs are salicylic acids. They both, depending on your skin type, this is what's important too, is you just always have to know your skin type. Glycolic and lactic acids are really good for more of that dry, normal skin type. It helps to stimulate collagen production, exfoliates dead skin cells on the surface of your skin. The BHA is like salicylic acids. That's great for oily, acne-prone skin. It penetrates deep into the pores and kills acne bacteria. So you would use each one according to your skin type. And then you have physical exfoliation, which is scrubs, which people are used to, like a soft scrub using on your face, which I like those as well. You just have to always make sure, again, you're using the products according to your skin type. And then when you're doing a physical exfoliation with a scrub, you just don't want to be harsh onto your skin. But both ways of exfoliation are great. They help brighten the skin. And you're really going to, you'll see a difference in your skin either way. Did I go into too much detail with that, or was that?
No, you're great. I love everything.
Okay.
It was easy to ask you because you know my skin. And so it was easy to ask you for products, and you recommended two great products. They were a little pricey, but they have lasted forever. I mean, that you know, if you use them according to the direction, they just last.
Yeah.
So do you have specific products that you recommend, or?
I do. There's, so like, for instance, with the AHAs and BHAs, there's different ways that you can use them. They're in serums. I have Is Clinicals and Active Serum I love. It has both AHAs and BHAs in it. I also love using pads, like retinol glycolic pads. From Skin Script is a good one. Dr. Dennis Grossman makes these peel pads that are great, that have both the AHA or BHA, again, depending on your skin type and the strength. Peter Thomas Roth has exfoliating pads. They're really great. They're really easy to use. And yeah, those are the ones that I recommend.
Yeah, Is Clinical.
I threw a lot at you. I just love products, so I could throw.
You recommended Is Clinical to me, and another one, and I love Is Clinical. It is the most amazing product. I put it on my husband, and he loved it. So
yeah.
Spa day at home. So
yeah, and you just always make sure, you know, products now have come a long way, and what I like about them is you're getting the purest form of the ingredients. You know, they're cleaner products now out there that are really going to help your skin and be beneficial without having all that extra stuff that, I mean, it's just come a long way with skincare products. So you can
definitely
be great. A little goes a long way, and you see the benefits of it fairly quickly, which is nice.
Definitely. So hopefully the beaches will be open soon and parks will be open. So how should we prepare our skin for when we finally see daylight?
Well, that's another thing, because we are going to be so excited to go back out there. You know, protecting your skin. What I do recommend to it and throughout there is using a vitamin C during the day. Vitamin C is great. It's going to protect your skin from sun damage. Helps with fine lines, wrinkles. It's one of the best antioxidants, I feel like, for your skin. So that's something good to use during the day. And then, of course, everyone's going to have to wear sunscreen and hats when they go out there, because we're all going to get out there at one time. All together, all at once, and we're not going to want to come back inside. So it's just going to be important to really just take care of your skin, you know, hats, sunscreens, hydrate. Everything we talked about. And of course, being careful what you do use at home. If you are on acne medications, if you're doing retinols, that's going to make your skin sun sensitive too. So you've just got to really be careful with what you're using at home and just take that in consideration when we get out there again and want to stay hours and hours in the sun. Because I'm going to want to be outdoors again for a long period of time. That's for sure.
Yeah, and I love Nikki's hat. I just love your hat.
I know, it's so nice. But I wish I could wear hats, Nikki. I kept looking at your hat.
I wear a lot of them. I actually did my own color this morning, you guys, and I got really distracted with my daughter and making breakfast and doing things, and I left it on too long and it overprocessed it. And that has never happened in my whole career. I've never overprocessed anyone's hair except my own. It's okay though. I know how to deal with it. So that's the good news.
Yeah. The good thing is you do know how to fix it and fix it quickly.
So. I do.
So I want to thank you both today for being with us and answering all the questions. And I personally feel very empowered to be with these leading ladies in the community and with very successful businesses. And I hope when we reopen, you're going to be just, I know you're going to be flooded with just oodles of clients and even more successful, because
we miss our clients, our conversations, and it's, you know, clients are texting all the time that they miss us, and it's that's nice to hear too, you know, that we're all, it's mutual for all of us.
Oh yeah, it's been good.
So. Well, it's interesting because you have a job that involves talking all day long.
Yeah,
what you do is you confide, you talk, and all of a sudden your doors were closed, and now you're talking to 3 and 5 year olds. So
exactly. You're the reason why we need our psychologist to go talk to.
Yes. I've never made so many snacks. I'm like, everything's a snack. I need another snack. I'm like, do you really? Or are you just bored?
So true. For myself, snacks.
Yeah.
Well, this whole thing has been, it's been trying, but it's also been a test that I think I've seen everybody I know come through with flying colors.
Yeah.
We're tough. We live in a great community. We're lucky to live in a great community where everybody is one-minded, more or less. Even those that aren't are still working together. We look at other areas of the country where it's not working out so well. So yes, we are lucky. We're so thankful for people like you in our community. And thank you so much for joining us today.
Yeah, thank you for having us.
Thank you.
Thank you. I get no doubt.